Ratings. During 1999, WWF's largest rating demographic viewers were teens, under 18. Where Stone Cold got the most rating points over The Rock, here are the facts.
Showcased at hundreds of arenas around the country, fans can't seem to get enough. It appeals to all ages, and as you might expect, a large part of the audience is children.
Why do you like Stone Cold?
I love
him! And wrestling companies are cashing in, selling kids everything from action figures to video games to clothing. And WWF's most popular wrestler, Stone Cold Steve Austin, can be seen guzzling beer and routinely making obscene hand gestures.
This is entertainment with a capital E.
Hey guys, how you doing?
This is Vince McMahon, president and driving force behind the phenomenal success of the WWF. His brawn is as big as his brain, and he writes himself into most of the show's storyline.
It's skyrocketed in the last 2 years, though.
Yes.
I mean, it's gone from good to phenomenal.
It's skyrocketed because of one reason, and that's our creative direction.
The ratings for McMahon's Monday Night Raw show have hit an all-time high, doubling in the last year. With kids and teens 17 and under making up a third of the audience. And McMahon offers no apologies for the raw content that kids find so appealing.
In 1999, Fox Network did an award show based on teen ratings demographics, a category on favorite wrestler, and Austin won, beating out other popular wrestlers like Hulk Hogan, Goldberg, and The Rock.
I'm a nominee for favorite wrestler, most popular wrestler, something like that. I think I'm keeping some pretty good company, so we'll see what happens.
The Rattlesnake's keeping good and familiar company. Other nominees in the Teen Choice Pro Wrestler category include The Rock and The Undertaker.
For me, it's a good deal to win because, you know, our teen audience is a good demographic to hit. When you look at every bit of the audience you're trying to reach, this is a big part of it. I try to reach all of them, but this says, yeah, this is the one I got the most of.
And the Teen Choice Pro Wrestler is Stone Cold Steve Austin.
The teens made their choice, and Stone Cold Steve Austin picked up the 1999 Teen Choice Award for Favorite Wrestler.
If you're having a good time, give me a hell yeah. Most time at work, I get to swing a steel chair at my victims. I think this might be a very creative alternative. So if this man is watching and you see me walking around with a surfboard under my arm, that means just don't turn your back. I got a real cool job and I thank you very much. And that's the bottom line. Because Stone Cold said so. For me, it's a good deal to win because, you know, our teen audience is a real, you know, it's a good demographic to hit. So to know that, you know, I came out number one in this particular demographic is cool for me.
Kind of mingle around and not talk to a few people. Basically, it's a night off for me, and I'm happy to be here as the first, Teen Choice Awards. Great reception from the teens, and as far as demographics go, with the World Wrestling Federation, it's a very large part of our audience, and who I am and what I do within our organization, caters a lot to that, demographic, but I also take pride in any age group. But to be here is it's a good time. I always get a good reception with this age group.
The highest rated moment of 1999. A lot of people say that The Rock's This Is Your Life segment was the highest rated moment of 1999 with 8.4, but actually, it was Stone Cold vs. The Undertaker with 9.5. Here's what wrestling journalist Dave Meltzer said on the matter. The Austin vs. Undertaker match did a monstrous 9.5 rating, making it the most watched wrestling match, or segment, in cable TV history and was the first match to ever break 10 million viewers. It actually did almost 11 million. Literally one in every six TV sets in America with access to cable was watching this match. I mention this because there's some controversy here. To this day, WWE, and Vince Russo in particular, constantly claims that the Rock/Mankind This Is Your Life segment was the highest rated segment in Raw history. Not true. This match beat it by more than a full ratings point. Now, to be fair, this match happened during the overrun at the end of Raw. Nitro had already gone off the air, so Undertaker vs. Austin didn't have competition and a lot of people switched over from Nitro to catch the end of Raw. So you could argue that this number is artificially inflated, while the Rock/Mankind thing happened in the middle of the show. But that notwithstanding, the factual answer to what was the highest rated match/segment/whatever in Raw history is not that this is your life segment. It's Undertaker vs. Austin on June 28, 1999. Stone Cold's impact on ratings for WWF and TV series Nash Bridges.
The superstar of the WWF, Stone Cold Steve Austin. A foul-mouthed, beer-guzzling Texan whose trademark is a raised middle finger and whose slogan is,
"Hell yeah!"
His on-screen battle royale with Vince McMahon helps pull the WWF out of the rating slump.
Today's wrestling heroes are everywhere. Stone Cold Steve Austin's appearance propelled Nash Bridges to its highest rating of the season on CBS.
He acted in two episodes of Nash Bridges last season. Bringing such big ratings, he's appearing in five more shows this year as cop Jake Cage.
Who's supplying you?
You don't get it, man. I'm done. I'm over. I'm gonna kill myself, and I'll kill you too.
If you want to die, man, I'll help you. Now give me a name. Give me the name.
Put the lighter down. Put it down. Uh-huh. Now turn around.
Nash Bridges.
Jay?
Now for the full head-to-head rating viewership. Sources. The numbers were done by OSW History, data sourced from Meltzer's Observer Archives cross-referenced with the PWI Pro Wrestling Illustrated Almanac from 1999 to 2000. The Rock. 99 segments. 16,393,806. Stone Cold. 62 segments. 16,441,284. Merchandise. Source: Wrestling Observer Newsletter. Now there are no official numbers for The Rock and Steve Austin's merchandise sales from 1999, but Austin still holds the record for most merchandise sold in a single year. Stone Cold, 1998, 13 million. The Rock, 2000, 11 million. A lot of people say that The Rock was outselling Austin in merchandise sales in late 1999. Simply because he had more items on WWF ShopZone top 10 list, which don't show sales figures. I would like to give you an example. As you can see, The Rock did dominate the list in late 1999, but that doesn't mean he was outselling Austin. Because if you go on to the summer of 2000, The Rock's peak, it shows that Too Cool and Rikishi dominated the list. Their sunglasses were number one. So does that mean they were outselling The Rock?
What a load of crap.
Box office. Primary data source, Dave Meltzer Wrestling Observer Newsletter. Other sources used: PW Torch, PWInsider, One Wrestling, and Powerslam Magazine. The Wrestling Observer has confirmed Steve Austin as the biggest box office draw in 1999, taking into account all house shows, big and small, and pay-per-view buy rates. No one has broken his total box office totals from 1998 to 1999 to date, and this might never change. The Rock drew the biggest gates in 1999 and 2000, counting big shows only 10,000 plus, and he was also working more shows than Stone Cold due to Austin being injured and not being able to work as much from mid-1999 onward. When looking at the month-by-month domestic attendance total, February 1999 has the highest average attendance, with Stone Cold Steve Austin as headliner act.
The phenomenon called professional wrestling rode a crest in 1999 that hadn't peaked. Explaining its popularity is difficult, but its appeal is undeniable. With a street named for him, it is obvious that Stone Cold's influence is extraordinary. He is the main event in the World Wrestling Federation, which produces three television shows a week. There are more than 60 officially licensed products with Stone Cold's likeness on them, including dolls, skateboards. Steve gets a piece of the action. His t-shirts and hats are on display at events, evidence of his status as the top draw.
Wherever you go in the world, you can see Stone Cold Steve Austin shirts, hats, books, pens, even boots they're talking about now, and totally unbelievable of the paraphernalia that you can get with Stone Cold Steve Austin, anything that resembles him.
People buy checks with Stone Cold's face on them, and they drink milk because he tells them to. They tune into TV talk shows when he appears as a guest. Steve Austin is an icon.
Now the peak numbers for The Rock and Steve Austin as champions in 1999 for domestic house show attendance. The Rock, third championship, 14 house shows, 13,112. Stone Cold, third championship, 11 house shows, 14,307. To this day, no one has broken Austin's record.
Give me a hell yeah!
That's the bottom line. The Stone Cold Sets Up.